I'm slinging in the rain, just slinging in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm flying again. I'm laughing at the clouds.
And welcome back to another flying vlog. I get to fly the South African Sling LSA. We encountered a light shower as we approached Cessnock. Thus, I was slinging in the rain. Anyway, I parked the sling and got a pie and coffee. I also checked out the Hunter Valley Visitor Information Center, got lots of brochures and ideas. All in all, it was a good day for a flight, and I can't wait to make more trips in the sling soon. As usual, leave a like and subscribe as we roll the flight vlog. Let's go flying. Hello there, and welcome back to my flight vlog. Today is Sunday, the 13th of August, and we are flying the sling. Let's have a quick look around. This Sling LSA is a two-place light aircraft with a max takeoff weight of 600 kilograms. It is powered by a Rotex 912 ULS engine and a Garmin G3X panel for avionics. It cruises at 105 knots indicated and burns approximately 22 liters of F-gas an hour. Overall, an economical light cruiser. Okay, that's a quick look around. Let's hop in and get on our way.
Transponder is set to on. DI, don't worry about it. Make the call to tower.
Bankstown Tower, Lima Hotel. Hotel is at holding point Charlie, runway 11 left, ready for a crosswind departure.
Lima Hotel, Hotel Tower, runway left, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, runway 11 left, Lima Hotel, Hotel.
Okay. Off, let's go. Landing lights are on, strobes are on. Flaps to one stage. Good on that side. Hey, okay, line up. Heels on the floor. Ready. Advancing the throttle. Full throttle full, RPM achieved, T-Sam T's in the green, airspeed is already live, that's very good, waiting for 60, 65, let's go.
So we've departed Bankstown and we are now currently flying over the city of Parramatta and thus beginning our journey north towards Hunter Valley. Now if we're making this trip by car and I'm using Google Maps, it estimated a 2 hour 20 minutes drive covering approximately 170 kilometers. Now if we take a very fuel efficient car like the Honda Jazz, we would be consuming about 11 liters of petrol for this trip. And conversely, by using Oz Runway's app, my planned flight would take approximately 45 minutes, thus saving about 1.5 hours compared to driving. And I'll be covering a distance of 76 nautical miles, which translates to about 140 kilometers, so I save 30 kilometers as well. With the sling, we will be consuming 15 liters for the flight. We will then round that up to about 20 liters because of taxi and run-ups on the ground. So it would consume more fuel, and of course F gas is more expensive than petrol. So your trip will still be more expensive, but you save on time.
Hey, where are we?
No, I'm not lost. I observed a massive water sports event at 2 o'clock low. Picked up my map to locate the name of the area. It's funny, in hindsight, because I have the Garmin G3X glass panel with GPS and map in the sling, but my nav training kicked in and I picked up my physical map instead. Anyway, I worked out that the body of water is north of Atalong Beach, and when I googled it later, I found out through the Coast Community News website that it was a water skiing selection trials on that weekend. Now I know about Gosford and their newly reopened wharf, and the name of the body of water is Brisbane Water.
Cessnock traffic, Sling Lima Hotel, 4,500 feet, 10 nautical miles south. Estimating time 5:05. Intentions are for a full stop on runway 35. Cessnock traffic.
Where's the view? At the view. Yep, I can see the airport now. I can see Cessnock right in front of me. Should I descend to the dead side?
Cessnock traffic helicopter, Mike Lima Kilo. Set base, runway 35 for Cessnock traffic system.
Circuit is 1,200 feet.
Traffic, Sling Lima Hotel is on a dead side runway 35, joining midfield crosswind for a full stop on runway 35, so it's on traffic. Lima Hotel is now laid downwind for runway 35 full stop. Cessnock traffic.
Okay, power back, and then do a full flap. Slow us down.
Cessnock traffic, Lima Hotel is final, runway 35, full stop. Cessnock traffic.
There you go. Okay, got a long runway, no problem. Let it glide down, just like. There you go, that's nice. Landed.
Cessnock traffic. Lima Hotel Hotel is clear of all active runways, taxiing towards the 1000. Cessnock traffic.
That's it guys, landed at Cessnock. Let's go and see if I can get myself a coffee.
Well, made it all the way to Cessnock. Just in time before the cafe closes behind me. Got myself a cup of coffee and a nice curry chicken pie. Note to self, if I'm ever coming here for lunch, I need to come here a lot earlier because the cafe closed at 2:30. Made it in just before the little rain came in as well, so I'm just going to take my time, wait for the rain to stop. So I'm even better clearer weather if possible. If not, I can just kind of climb out, not a problem. Cloud base is fairly high, visibility is more than 5 kilometers, even in this condition, and I can just fly towards the coast and then head back towards Sydney and Bankstown. So yeah, this is my very first trip as a private pilot. Not under instruction, not under a navigation exercise. I'm just simply flying up here for a coffee and a meal.
And now it's time for the return flight. The showers of light rain continued westward and the flight back to Bankstown was uneventful. I forgot to switch my camera back to 360 mode, so the field of view ain't great. So I'm just fast forwarding a small selection of the clips here as we bring this flight vlog to a close. I'm very new to content creation on YouTube, and a short video like this takes hours across many evenings for me to put together. I appreciate you're still watching this video at this point. Please feel free to ask me any questions in the comments section below. Your feedback and suggestions are most welcome, and it will help me shape the future content on this channel. Thank you for watching, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers!